Carlisle. We got Follow, and Follow Pretty Good and Happy. And then we did The Story, so we did The Story, Downpour, and Josephine. And then from Give Up the Ghost, we did Raise Hell, Dreams, that's Bear Creek. We did Dreams, I Will, and Before a Break. And then from Bear Creek, we did Raise Hell, That Wasn't Me, and Our Way Home. And then we did a cover tune, and then we did a tune from Firewatcher. And now I'm going to play you guys a song for the next record. My daughter Evangeline, the other morning, I'm laying in bed. Me and my wife Catherine and Evangeline, we have our like 45 minutes of cuddle time in the bed every morning, and it's great. This is when she talks the most, you know. She's really aloof, very feminine. Her, you know, my sister, it's like me and my sister feel like we had like daughter swap. Like, she's got this weird, quirky little kid with like thin curls and like, you know, Doc Martens, and she won't walk flat feet. She has to wear a leg brace, and she just, you know, she's like this little tomboy, weirdo, quirky person that just like wears a Nirvana t-shirt all the time. And then I have this daughter that just says she wants to be a princess. She's got painted nails and toes. She's got long, less, like luxurious curly hair. She's just super beautiful. And so she actually is supposed to like belong to my sister, and then my sister's Joe is supposed to belong to me. And it's just everything about her personality. It's just, she's a little bit glamorous. So she says to the other morning, she takes my hand and she puts it on my wife's hand. And she points to our wedding rings, our really plain tomboy wedding rings. And she goes, "What's that?" And I said, "Oh, that's Mommy and Mama's, you know, wedding rings." And she goes, "Oh, why?" And I said, "Well, because Mommy and Mama are married." She goes, "Okay." She's got this new thing because she watches Dora, where like, if she sees something that she wants, she goes, "What do we need?" So she goes, "I want to get married." And I was like, "Well, you can when you grow up." And she goes, "What do we need?" And I go, "Well, you need to love someone." And she goes, "We need a man." She says, "We need a man, Mom." I'm like, "You know, we do need a man around here, I'll tell you what." But it was so funny. She says, "We need a man." That child was born to challenge my existence. She was born to two mothers on Father's Day. She was just sent here to fuck me up. So I wrote this song about her, and everything about Evangeline is beautiful and special and inconvenient and terrible. And I just feel that it's really important to tell both sides of that story, so apologies. Called the mother. Welcome to the end of being alone inside your mind. You're tethered to another and you're worried all the time. You always know the melody, but you never heard it rhyme. She's fair and she is quiet, Lord. She doesn't look like a She made me love the morning, she's a holiday at sea. The New York streets are as busy as they always used to be. But I am the mother of Evangeline. First things that she took from me were selfishness and sleep. She broke 1,000 heirlooms I was never meant to keep. She filled my life with color, canceled plans, and trashed my car. But none of that was ever who we are. Outside of my windows are the mountains and the snow. I hold you while you're sleeping, and I wish that I could go. Oh, my rowdy friends are out accomplishing their dreams. But I am the mother of Evangeline. And they still got their and they still enjoy our evenings with the skeptics and the wine. Oh, but all the wonders I have seen, I will see a second time. From inside of the ages, through your eyes. You are not an accident where no one thought it through. The world that stood against us made us mean to fight for you. When we chose your name, we knew that you'd fight the power too. You're nothing short of magical and beautiful to me. Oh, never hit the big time without you. So they can keep their treasure and their ties to the machine. 'Cause I am the mother of